you look at the cave paintings in the south of France, it's full of animals behaving, and some of the behaviour is beautifully observed. Two, decades of work by scientists go behind our good television programmes, and that's how we know so much about things like meerkats. Scientists have spent decades working in the desert, mapping the family relationships of these animals. Three, is our behaviour and that of other animals simply down to our genes, that's nature, or is it the environment, nurture? And in a way, it's a silly question because both are involved. Four, epigenetics. It basically means the way that genes are turned on and off, and these certainly affect behaviour. One nice example is in mice. Their behaviour as adults is affected by how much their mother licks them when they're young. Five, all mammals seem to have play when they're young. So whether we're talking about children, kittens, or puppies, they all play. Six, when a honeybee colony reaches a certain size, half the colony goes away with the queen in a swarm. The swarm sends out scouts to find a new hollow tree. When a scout comes back, she performs a waggle dance and convinces other bees that hers is the best site. Seven, animals and humans communicate. One of the best examples that's been studied recently is the greater honey guide in Mozambique. When the honey guide wants some honey itself, it approaches a village and gives a special call to the people in the village, a special chattering call. And when people respond, the bird will lead them to a bee's nest. Eight, ants always seem to find cake at picnics. What's happening is that scout ants are covering the whole of the neighbourhood, but when they find your cake, they go straight back to the nest, laying a pheromone trail as they walk. Nine, we are also getting an acidification of the oceans. And lots of marine animals rely on smell. Smell works just as well underwater. And unfortunately, as things become more acid, smell stops working. 10. Some birds show amazing feats of memory, remembering where they put food many months before in thousands of different places, and that's how they survive the winter. London taxi drivers have to learn some 25,000 roads and routes, and when they're learning, the part of the brain that expands is the hippocampus, and that's just the same as those scatter-hoarding birds.